arrested a key suspect in the murder of rationalist Narendra Dabholkar. 5 years on after the 67-year-old was shot dead in Pune, the CBI has arrested a man identified as Sachin Prakash Rao Andure from Aurangabad in Maharashtra. He was allegedly one of the shooters who fired at Dabholkar on the 20th of August 2013 in Pune city while he was out for his morning walk. Now, this arrest was made on the basis of the statement of another accused who allegedly confessed before the Maharashtra ATS.
This has been almost after 2.5 years of arrest of Virendra Tavde, the first culprit. I think this is a very important step in right direction as far as the investigation is concerned. And now we hope that CBI won't stop here and they will try and identify the masterminds behind this heinous act.
And Santhya Gora now joining us live to get us more on the story. Santhya, this is a big development here. Tell us more about the one who's been arrested and what kind of links have been established to the Gauri Lankesh murder case as well, because we're given to understand this is also being seen as some kind of a link that may lead up to the murderers of Gauri Lankesh as well.
See, as far as Sachin Andure is concerned, he was arrested by ATS yesterday and later on he was handed over to CBI because CBI is the investigating agency for the Dabholkar murder case. And if we talk about his whereabouts, he was in Aurangabad since 2016 and he secured a job for himself in the textile industry of the area. He was living in a rented house with his wife and daughter. And it was the link, if we talk about the link, he was also linked to Hindu organizations, specifically Hindu Jan Jagriti Samiti. And if we talk about how ATS got the clue about Sachin Andure, when ATS made an arrest of three people, including Vaibhav Raut, on 10th of August, all these three people were planning a terror activity in five areas of Maharashtra, and they were arrested by ATS, and a very massive cache of arms and ammunition was also recovered by ATS. And when ATS was interrogating all these three accused, one of these three accused, Sharad Kalaskar, he accepted that in his confessional statement to ATS, he said that he himself was directly involved with the murder of rationalist Narendra Dabholkar, who was shot dead on 20th August 2013. Based on Sharad Kalaskar's inputs and his confessional statement, he also named Sachin Andure. He said Sachin Andure was that one person who apparently shot Narendra Dabholkar dead. And based on his input, ATS conducted raids and ATS made this arrest. Sachin Andure was arrested by ATS yesterday itself and then handed over to CBI. But now here, if we talk about the links with Gauri Lankesh murder case, since the very beginning when all these three accused, Vaibhav Raut, Sharad Kalaskar and Sudhan Wab, all three of them were arrested, since that time ATS was giving hints that how these three people can also be linked with those who assassinated Narendra Dabholkar, Govind Pansare, Kalburgi, and in fact Gauri Lankesh also. So that's the reason ATS was actually interrogating these three people on those lines as well. And here is the first breakthrough when one of the accused has confessed that he was directly involved with the murder of Narendra Dabholkar. And now ATS is interrogating that how exactly were these three accused and now these three accused are related with Gauri Lankesh murder case also. On the other hand, CBI is also interrogating Sachin Andure on the same lines.
Right, so this is clearly a big breakthrough in the Dabholkar murder case, Santhya, for the ATS. 5 years on, a big breakthrough taking place in the murder case here. But if we speak about the investigation, what is the line of investigation at the moment? Is this case being seen as cracked, or there are more there is a possibility of more arrests taking place, because at this point in time two arrests have already been taken place? What is the CBI's line of investigation likely to be now?
See, if we talk about CBI's line of investigation, when in 2016 CBI arrested Dr. Virendra Tavade, who was linked with Hindu Janjagriti Samiti, an organization affiliated to Sanatan Sanstha, at that time CBI also filed a charge sheet in the court. But at that time, CBI named two other people as the one who shot Narendra Dabholkar. One was Vinay Pawar, and the and there was another person, Akolkar, called Akolkar. And Akolkar was in fact on the he's also there in the in the Interpol's red corner notice list. He's a red corner notice has been issued against him. That was before 2016, because he's allegedly involved with more crimes as well before the assassination of Dr. Narendra Dabholkar. So if we talk about CBI's line of investigation, CBI's clear line of investigation will be to find out whose role was what. Because if we talk about the murder of Dr. Narendra Dabholkar, and if we focus on the CCTV footage which was available at that time, there are two bikers who are seen on a bike, and one of them shot Narendra Dabholkar. But and when CBI filed a charge sheet, the CBI named Akolkar and Pawar as those two shooters. But now there is this other person who has in his confessional statement has accepted that he was the one who shot Dr. Dabholkar dead. So as of now, CBI has to first figure out whose role was what, who was the real assassin. And also based on all the literature and other evidences which were seized from Dr. Virendra Tavade as well, they have to set up links that whether these were the same people who conducted the assassination of Gauri right. Lankesh, the journalist, and Kalburgi as well. Because since the very beginning, all these investigating agencies, to one point which they are reaching is that how there is a huge possibility that all these assassinations have taken place and motivated by one organization, one umbrella organization. So that's that one thing these investigating agencies have to establish.